What's up, guys? Here is 7 minutes of useless information about Ezreal. Also, I just started streaming again on Twitch, so feel free to come by and say hi sometime. And of course, Puppy. Let's go. A long time ago, like when Ezreal was just released, it looked like Riot was going to release a Rick Astley Ezreal skin, but it unfortunately was never released. This was the actual skin texture leaked out, but maybe Riot was just rickrolling us the whole time. There's a lot of people who think the silhouette in the flash icon is actually Ezreal. And this person even took the time to fill in some more of the details to prove that point even further. This person made an Ezreal shadow box, which is basically like a 3D poster. It's completely handmade, and it was done by layering a bunch of different photo paper on top of each other. I can't even imagine how much time this took, but it definitely paid off because this thing looks sick. Ezreal has had some pretty crazy voice actors. Kyle Erber was the original voice actor, but the new Ezreal is voiced by Daniel Ammerman. Daniel has a huge voice acting background, doing things like Disney ads and even McDonald's commercials.
Everyone loves getting more, and there's something for everyone to love on the new dollar menu and more at McDonald's, like crunchy, tangy new tastes and the flavor of thick-cut applewood bacon.
On top of that, he also appeared as an actor in shows like Glee, CSI, and even The Office. Oh, and most importantly, Ken from Barbie.
Woohoo! Road trip!
Sorry you had to see that. The Japanese voice actor for Ezreal is also no slouch in the voice acting world and has done work for a ton of different animes such as Haikyuu, Demon Slayer, and he is even Sai from Naruto. Ezreal is around 20 years old. Ezreal can use magic without his gauntlets, but he's gotten so used to it that he kinda relies on it now. If he put in the effort, he really wouldn't need it, but Ezreal's so lazy by nature that he'd rather just take the shortcut. Same, bro. On that note, Ezreal is kind of the student that everyone hates the most. You know, the ones that don't have to study but still ace every single test? Yeah, he's one of those guys. These were some of the very first Ezreal models released in the game, and I swear this is what it would look like if Freddy and Velma had a kid together. That or if Harry Potter bleached his hair a little too long. The blue triangles under Ezreal's eyes are expressions of magic that appear when he's channeling or using arcane abilities. Ezreal's gauntlet originally belonged to a Shuriken tyrant named Nuzik, who actually created Malphite. But did you know that there are actually two gauntlets instead of just the one? But not even Ezreal knows about it because it was already gone by the time he got there. Who knows, maybe Riot has a plan for it in the future lore and will bring it back one day. Ezreal has a fake name he uses when traveling in Demacia called Jarrow Lightfeather. Also, a jar of Lightfeather is also the name of Ezreal's hair gel. According to Riot employee Fox Shizzle, if Ezreal snaps his gauntlet, the universe doubles in size. Thanos may have something to say about that. For the most part, Ezreal is ambidextrous. Ezreal has a quote where he says,
"Yordles. Why did it have to be Yordles?"
Which is a reference to Raiders of the Lost Ark. Ezreal also has a quote where he says,
"Gauntlet? You're embarrassing me in front of the bad guys!"
Which is a reference to Avengers Infinity War.
"Dude, you're embarrassing me in front of the wizards."
Overall, Ezreal has probably the most quote references out of any champion I've seen so far. He has one for Dragon Ball Z, Back to the Future, Super Mario Bros., Portal, Indiana Jones, The Phantom Menace, and The Empire Strikes Back.
"Never tell me the odds."
Potato Ezreal. Frog Ezreal.
"Ezreal was the first champ to get a champion spotlight, so I guess you could say Freak lost his vocal virginity to this blonde beauty. You can cast a bursty boy Q right before flashing to catch unsuspecting scrubs off guard. He doesn't have a map or a college degree, but he does have a wildly successful talk show where he's had guests like Ninja appear before. Ezreal is one of those champions who you can just look at and immediately think, yeah, he definitely bleaches his butthole hairs.
Are you not intrigued?"
That was an image I did not think was going in my head today. But thanks, Raf. RuneScape 3, yes, the dumb version of RuneScape, added Ezreal as an NPC for the Archaeology Guild. The first thing he says when he talks to you is, "Everything belongs in a museum." Battle Academia Ezreal was inspired by Midoriya by My Hero Academia. Ezreal was the first champion to cost 6,300 IP on release. This person created an Osu version of Ezreal, if that's even possible. And I have to say, if I've learned anything from this, it's how crazy Ezreal's W hitbox is. Pretty freaking crazy though, I can't imagine how much time this took. Ezreal's dance is a reference to the Haruhi dance. Ezreal was the first champion to have a skillshot ability that can give buffs to his allies, but it was later reworked. Ezreal's W used to heal your teammates, and then later it was made so he would give attack speed to anyone hit by it, including himself. He could actually E or flash into his W to hit himself and gain that extra attack speed. Nowadays, if you try it, you'll just look stupid, so don't do it. Or do it. All of Ezreal's abilities used to have different names. Mystic Shot used to be called Vector Shot. Essence Flux used to be called Chains of Light. Arcane Shirt used to be called Dimensional Pocket. And True Shot Barrage used to be called True Shot Blast. One of Ezreal's abilities was going to be a targeted short-range nuke that would knock back the target. There was a Reddit post over 5 years ago where someone asked, what would Shyvana do if Ezreal kissed her leg? The best part about this post is everyone flew to the comments thinking this was some kind of meme post or there was some kind of punchline to it, but no, this was a legit question from somebody and it left a lot of people confused. It even got enough upvotes to land itself on the popular page, and people from other communities were coming in making sure everybody was okay.
Came in expecting great pun. Left extremely confused. Hi, I'm from R-All. Are you guys okay? No, please send help. And cookies. At this point I think we need to clear the cookies.
Later Wright even gave Ezreal a quote where he says,
aim for the legs.
Explorer Ezreal is a reference to the Internet Explorer. Pulsefire Ezreal was originally going to be called Cyber Ezreal, but one of the devs said it didn't make any sense, so it was later changed. In France, Pulsefire Ezreal is also called Mega Ezreal as a reference to Mega Man. When Pulsefire Ezreal recalls, he'll either grab a Heart of Stone, a Cage's Lucky Pick, or Philosopher's Stone before entering the portal under him, which are all discontinued League items, in case you didn't know. Arcade Ezreal has a picture of Baron Nashor as a space invader on his shirt. Pew! When you W auto a turret with a Battle Academia Ezreal, a sword will come down on top of it. Ezreal thinks he's so attractive that Lux should have a crush on him, but she really has no idea who he is. Meanwhile, Zoe has a huge crush on Ezreal. During one of Ezreal's expeditions, he was attacked by void creatures but was saved by Kai'Sa, which was also referenced in the Warrior cinematic. But to be honest, all the cinematic really shows was Ezreal being a little wuss. The dude took out one void creature and thought he was hot stuff. The dude in the top shop on Howling Abyss is actually Ezreal's uncle Light. Ezreal is by far the most popular champion in the game, picked 24.1% of the time. To put it into perspective, the next closest is Lee Sin at 19.1%. The player with the most masteries on Ezreal is Ezreal Carry from the EUNE server with 4,510,795 million mastery points. If you look really carefully at the original Ezreal skin splash art, you can see a rock. Thanks for watching, bye!